Boxing superstar Floyd Money Mayweather has a poll going on. Coach Cliff, the poll is, who do you want to see Floyd Mayweather fight next? Do you want to see him fight Amir Khan? Do you want to see him fight Marcos Maidana? Today's the last day to vote. Did you vote, Coach?
No, because I went up on the site and, you know, wanted me to do some bunch of registration or some stuff, and I don't have patience for that kind of stuff. If you want me to vote, I'll vote, but if you got to do a bunch of stuff, hoops, you know, I don't want to be part of your email blast.
What do you mean? There are no easy shortcuts in life. Just like a fighter comes in here and wants to fight, you have to train first.
Yeah,
you have to work for it.
But
you can't just give it away. Let's look at it from both perspectives. If Amir Khan fights Mayweather, what do you see happening?
I think it'll look fine for a few rounds, and then somewhere about 5 or 6, Amir will get excited, and then he'll get knocked out.
Now, if Marcos Maidana fights Mayweather, how do you see that fight going?
I think it goes the distance. I think Maidana does good for the first 2 or 3 rounds, but Mayweather, like he always does, he adapts to whatever you're doing, learns your tricks, learns your timing. He starts getting in that counter-punching, and then he's first, and then pretty much he's messed you up, and he wins... 7 rounds to 5 or 8 rounds to 4.
If it's not one of these two, because Maidana and Khan are going back and forth on Twitter, if it's a different opponent, who would you want to see Mayweather fight?
Well, I just always wanted to see him fight Pacquiao, so I still wanted to see him fight Pacquiao. I know it's a lot. They'll never set it up, but that's what I want to see. I mean, I'd be really excited to see that.
People say Pacquiao, people say Ruslan Dilara, people say there are a lot of stuff that they're saying, but Manny has something on his plate right now called Tim Bradley. He's fighting him April 12th. What do you think about that fight? Does Manny have a chance?
I think Manny has a chance. I mean, I like Tim Bradley, but I thought Manny eked it out last time. I really did. I thought he won that fight, and I think that was just payback for the Marquez fight where
Marquez
won. And Marquez, Pacquiao 3. Marquez really won that fight with deeper, better punches. They gave that one to Pacquiao, and I think they just took it away from him this time. I think he was doing better against Bradley, and I think he won at least 7 of those rounds.
So yesterday I was at a gym, and there was an argument. Is Floyd Mayweather the best ever? And I told him yes. He's the best I've ever seen.
You know, skill-wise, he's certainly one of the best ever. My hesitation with him is I don't feel like he's fought everyone. And there's been fighters in the past, Sugar Ray Leonard and Chavez, not Chavez earlier in his career, but and not junior, senior, early in his career where, you know, he didn't fight everybody. But I thought by the end he fought everybody. Look, you compare him to Manny, I think Mayweather's going to win. He's bigger. And Mayweather has some more skills than Manny. But Manny has really taken on quite a few challengers. Now, you can argue that they're slightly over the hill, but they're also a lot bigger.
But, Coach,
I think he's taken on a lot more opponents outside his comfort zone than Mayweather has. Mayweather picks his opponents more carefully.
I would have to agree to disagree because Floyd basically fights the guys first, then Manny fights him.
Yeah, but I mean, Manny.
I mean, you look at Mosley, Floyd fought him first. Look at Hatton, Floyd. Marquez, Manny fought Marquez first, then Floyd. And you can say Cotto, Manny fought first, then Floyd, but they're fighting the same guys pretty much. So you can't really say that Floyd's not fighting people. He's fighting everybody. He fought De La Hoya much younger. Manny fought De La Hoya in his last fight as a pro. Pacquiao never fought.
But Manny is doing more of a stretch there with weight. So, I mean.
But a lot of catch weights. It hasn't been a full weight class.
For Mayweather to do the same thing, he needs to fight Marivella or something like that, where, hey, this guy's now a much bigger fighter, maybe towards the end of his career, but a much bigger fighter. And, you know, that's my knock on Mayweather. If he'd taken this Pacquiao fight earlier and taken on more opponents, I think I would be more impressed with his place in history. I don't think he's gotten the full test the way some other fighters have.
I think he's fought everybody. I think he's proven to be 45-0, and he's fought some really tough guys. He fought Canelo. The first everybody said, Floyd, you're avoiding Canelo. You'll never fight him. He fought Victor Ortiz when they said, here comes a young, hungry lion, and he has the plan.
But those, you know, to me, those were played up. I never thought Canelo had a chance against Mayweather. I just didn't. I mean, Mayweather's way.
He fought Corrales, Castillo.
Yeah.
He fought a lot of tough guys.
That was a tough fight. That was a good fight, yeah.
And in the rematch, he dismantled him.
Hey,
so.
Believe me, I'm not a Mayweather hater. I mean, he's up there with some of my favorite fighters. There's no question he's in my top 5. I just don't know if I can place him number 1 because he didn't face everybody he should have faced, in my opinion.
Basically, the only fight he didn't face, in your words, is Manny Pacquiao. Because well, everybody else he fought. Who do you want him to fight?
Who else did he fight?
Who do you want to fight? Klitschko?
No.
That's not realistic.
But he could fight some bigger guys.
What bigger guys?
160 pounds. Name some fighters at 160 now that are, right?
Gennady Golovkin?
Golovkin.
But why should he go up to one if he fights at 144, 145? That doesn't make sense.
Yeah, well, but it didn't make sense for Manny, but he did it and he beat those guys.
Yeah, but those guys were catchweights. He didn't really fight them at their real weight.
Fought De La Hoya at 147. That wasn't
and
a catchweight.
And De La Hoya had to drain himself of that fight.
Yeah, but De La Hoya took
and
that
he fought
fight.
Margarita at 150. Not 154. And those 4 pounds.
But look how big Margarito is in comparison. Margarito is a 154-pound fighter, and Pacquiao's 130, 135. That's a huge disparity of weight, in my opinion. I mean, that's just a big jump. And Manny took those jumps and took those chances. I'm also really impressed the way he got knocked out of Marquez and the way he's coming back. Like, nothing happened, man. He just brushed that off, like, brushed that shoulder off and moved on. I'm really impressed with that.
I remember that fight. That was a good one. That was the one that made Manny into a household name.
Yeah, now, in my opinion, De La Hoya lost too much weight.
And he was drained.
And he didn't gain it back. He could not rehydrate, and that was, he just wasn't, he wasn't healthy for that fight. I think that would have been different. A healthy De La Hoya, a big De La Hoya would have been different.
There you have it, Coach Cliff. So you're not voting by reason of what?
I don't like to get caught up in someone's email, Twitter, Facebook. It's funny. One of the things I don't like to get spammed. The other thing is I often watch the boxing on delay. So I'll come home on a Saturday night going out. I don't want to see a bunch of tweets and emails and stuff about who won. I haven't seen it yet. I want to see a
French. That's your logic. There you have it, Coach Cliff here at Outlaws. Stay tuned. And if you want to join USA Boxing, hit up Coach Cliff.
Yeah, I'm the USA Boxing Registrar in the San Fernando Valley. So.
All right, I'm going to come looking for you this year.
You come looking for me, man. I'll sign you up for the Masters.
There you have it. Stay tuned. VSNewsReporting.com. I'm Alexic Mike reporting, but I don't play golf.